What is up, everybody? Mega Brew here. Welcome to Monday Night Stream. Life is Strange Before the Storm. Game takes place 3 years before the events of Life is Strange. I really enjoyed Life is Strange. Looking forward to checking this out. The only thing is though, I don't know how much it's going to take advantage of like time manipulation, since this year focused on Chloe and Rachel. Okay. What's up, Bubble? What's up, Hazy? AKA the real Mega Bro. Sorry, I'm an imposter. Just a little bit here. Three episodes of this? Okay. Consequences. I did. I made you an approved user. But we're not doing song requests on this game. And yes, Proto is his friend.
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes! Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here.
This isn't the same voice actor. Or they couldn't get her because of the voice actor strike or whatever.
No trespassing? No way. Holy shit. This place is awesome. If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door.
Watch out, we got a badass here. Argument.
Those guys need to get a room. Or not. Damn.
Mind your own business. I understand.
Should
really
probably avoid getting on that guy's shit list. This RV's just begging for a little street art. But if I do it here, someone will see me.
Her walk is like, got a badass over here.
Ah, perfect place for me to work. Now, what to draw? Hey, kids! Free candy. I'm sorry, officer. It says what on the side of my RV?
Oh, so much stuff to read through. I guess I should read this to you guys, huh? Dear Max, Dad got me the stationery one day when I complained about wanting to send an email. The internet was down. Then I thought, hey, maybe it's time to write Max. Funny thing is, I don't really know what to say, because we haven't talked in 3 months, despite all my calls and texts. Not that I'm upset or anything. Fuck, there's no way I'm sending this, is there? Chloe the Unfriended. Now this is more like it. Here I can write to you all I want without wondering or worrying if you'll ever write me back. Maybe one day when you return home, apologize for having forgotten all about me and we kiss and make up. I'll show this to you and we can read it and laugh. Or maybe I'll decide that the journal Max is way cooler than reality Max and you'll just live in here forever as my little imaginary former current best friend pen pal. Time will tell. Chloe the Journal Boss. Ready? So mom suggests taking a road trip next summer and I'm like, cool, I guess. But then she starts talking about David being there. Yes, that David. The wannabe drill sergeant who swooped in on mom and has stuck around like a bad zit. David the mustache monster from Planet Dipshit. That fucking David. Anyway, I politely suggested to mom that perhaps it was too early to assume David would be in the picture by then, or breathing. Hey, shit happens, as you might imagine. That didn't go over too well. Really, if this guy's still around 3 months from now, then she's got some serious self-esteem issues, and I've got serious self-immolation. Look it up, nerd. Plans. She can do better. That's all I meant. But she didn't want to hear it. Like, I'm the asshole. But... Oh, wait. Oh. Max, so you know how I stopped going to class so much? Like, you stopped talking to me so much? Funny story. I had trouble coming up with an excuse, so I just didn't. I just didn't show up. And it was fine. Nobody said anything to me. Crazy, right? It's like I'm invincible all of a sudden. Or invisible. Invincible? It says invincible. Maybe that's the perk of being the dead dad girl. No one knows what to do with me, so they're actually relieved when I stay home. Wish I'd figured this out sooner. Think of all the wasted school time. P.S. Priss from the Blade Runner popped into my head last time I rubbed one. I mean, at first I was thinking about Deckard, that smolder of his, but then Pris just totally stole the show. Probably nothing there. Think I just want her bangs. Chloe the Electric Sheep. Bored of my reading already.
Guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here. This place has collected a lot of junk over the years. I'd join a motorcycle gang if I had any friends. Nothing says badass like a nice floral print. That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed. An old lumber car. Guess it's been years since anyone's actually worked here. I've got to figure out how to get past this guy.
Help you, miss?
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid. But you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him?
Hmm.
So Some say the world will end in fire. Mom would totally flip her shit if she knew I hiked for an hour just to see a show.
They get all their equipment out here. Well, I guess the RV.
Should probably avoid getting on that guy's shit list. Guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here. A second door inside? So close, and yet so far. This band shreds so hard. I gotta get in there.
Why are you yelling no, Bubble?
That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed.
You don't want me to do the reading?
Keep walking, kid. God, again? What do you want, kid?
Is that your bike over there?
Yup.
It's, pretty cool.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
This is the old mill, right? I heard Firewalk is playing here tonight. They're awesome.
Nope.
Are you kidding?
You should probably just go.
A backtalk challenge?
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside. Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
Isn't it past yours?
Real cute.
Oh, God.
But I still don't know you.
Kittens riding tiny mopeds are cute. I'm more like Red Sonja riding a panzer tank.
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
Maybe I am a kid, because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
A girl like you, with pretty, pretty flowers on her bicycle, shouldn't lecture me on what I can do.
That is a traditional Samoan... Look. My boss decides who gets in, all right?
Is your boss your mom? Follow up. Do you live in your boss's basement?
Oh, that was lame.
You're not accepting no for an answer, are you?
Nope.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid. Go on in.
Talk about some teen angst.
This is intense!
Shit!
Hey, Delia! Come!
Cute dog.
Watch out, we got a badass over here. Robot clown army.
Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrash. That dog is fierce. What's her name?
Delia. She doesn't usually like people.
Yeah, me neither. Sober up, girl. You're missing the show.
Don't mess with Damon. Thanks for the memo.
That shirt is rad.
No.
Is that guy selling merch?
Exactly as I've explained it to.
Wish I had some cash.
All right,
hey. Are you selling any...
$20.
What?
$20 for a t-shirt.
That's really expensive. Dick.
No. Look, we have to... Hey, I told you $20. You looking to get beat?
That guy's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative.
Does seem like Chloe's character just trying to see much trouble she can get into.
Yeah.
Total tanks.
No shit. This car could slide down any minute. Releasing that brake would roll the car right out from under that tool. Do I want a firewalk shirt that bad? I think I do. Sorry, dude. Maybe you shouldn't overcharge.
No! Come on!
Thanks for playing, Dick. Oh, yeah! Sweet, sweet victory.
Where'd she just put that?
That's like $200.
Playing with Chloe's character.
Holy shit! I'm rich! Nothing sadder than a neglected bong.
It does.
Sweet knife! Just like the one my mom refused to get me for my birthday. Sketch Central.
Sounds like she's trying way too hard to be like this.
Cold beer, free for the taking. Drink more, feel less. Yes, please. How can you just chill when Firewalk is tearing it up in the next room?
It's Frank.
Frank Bowers? What is he doing here? No thanks. I try to avoid hepatitis when I can. Classy. Yo, Frank!
Hey!
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot for me every month for a year. Look at that getup. Studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm here to see Firewalk, man. They rock.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
Ha, the internet.
How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
Okay, so you holding? I could definitely use something to take the edge off.
Of course. As soon as you give me the 175 bucks you owe me.
Hey, look.
Toss in a dime bag and we'll call it square.
Hey, hey! What are you waving around this kind of money here for? You really don't think before you act, do you?
Nope.
I'm totally playing a Chloe's character, not so much what I would do.
No more loans. I'm not your fucking piggy bank.
You're a good man, Frank.
No. I'm not. Now beat it, Price. You're cramping my style.
So, you come here a lot, or...?
Yeah.
Right. It's cool.
I'm really glad you approve.
I'll see you later.
Whatever.
Half those stairs are rotted through. Looks dicey. Graffiti everywhere. I think they missed a spot.
I like how her graffiti is with a Sharpie.
Sit and spit. $300 dock workers laid off, their pensions canceled? God, Prescott's a real tool.
Damn.
That's totally me in 5 beers. Okay, 3. Damn, there are a lot of people here. Here we go. Fuck.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
Fuck off, man.
Hey, you don't know who I am, do you?
No. And I give zero shits.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you, bitch.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine. Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above.
Dialogue.
She returns.
Did you see that guy I ran into? Acted like I was supposed to know who the hell he was.
Ah, yeah. I know him. He works for Damon.
Damon Merrick?
I see you've heard of him. This
Maybe
is
you don't
place.
Wanna.
Damon's a friend.
Just don't piss off Damon on the wall.
Where do those stairs go?
Up?
Real helpful, Frank. I mean, will I get a better view of the band up there?
How the fuck should I know? Floor above's rotted all to hell, okay? No one goes up there.
Fine.
And of course we're
going to
go up there.
Whatever.
And she's going to fall through.
Made it. I can't believe it.
Thank you.
not too bad. It's a little cringy. Writing's a little cringy at parts, but...
Beer, bitch.
You should be more careful. It's a rough place.
I don't like your attitude.
Then how about I show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer?
I think she's calling us out, dude.
She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It won't.
She thinks she can take you?
What do you guys think I should do? Attack or run? Attack it is. Oh, damn.
Rachel? Come on!
I don't guess we know how Chloe and Rachel met now.
Hurry up!
I'm caught up in a trance of you still arrogance. A voice is filled with pain. Lost, no one gave it toss. The notes of our slot. So the story.
Let me go, Frank! Not gonna happen. Calm down. Come on, man! Walk away! Screw this! Get the fuck out of here!
Sometimes, all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell. Hey, Max. Hey, Dad. Another day in paradise. Right?
Really went downhill after Max left.
Daily rituals are important, even when they involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you.
I'm gonna read over it real quick.
Rolling. Wakey, wakey, eggs and bacon.
Last night, seeing Firewalk live. The skeevy assholes. That girl. Was that really Rachel Amber? You smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes.
Man, I am killing it this year. Somehow I don't think Mom's going to feel the same way.
She's got C's, no F's.
Yeah, no one needs to see that. Thank you.
I'd like to think my humor has improved with age.
Terrible news, my fellow Oregonians. Our very own Pacific Steve's famous crab is shutting its doors. Might have something to do with all the health...
Better living through chemistry.
Day 420.
I'm perfectly capable of waking up without you, you know. Eventually. Wake and bake is part of a healthy breakfast.
That really was Rachel Amber. And she saved my life. How was last night even real?
One of these days, I'm actually going to use you to do my homework.
Ask Miss Arcadia. You're the only source of info I trust in this town. Wait, what? Who? What photo? I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings.
Supported by listeners like
that was so proud of me for winning that stupid science fair.
Anytime. Literally any amount.
Bask, ye mortals, in the light of the glowy bear. Used to dream of riding a unicorn as a kid, but then all the unicorns died.
No more unicorns, no more princesses, and no more fucking rainbows.
The edgy.
Words of graffiti. Wisdom, don't fail me now. Everything's worth a shot. Adapt or die. Fun fact. Shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child.
Nice one, Chloe. Mom's gonna love the new look.
Yeah, that's what happens when you get punched in the face.
I bet Long Max Silver traded her hat for beer and booty long ago. I used to love skateboarding. It's the only mode of transportation that doubles as a middle finger to authority.
Mom said I was too young to go. She was wrong, and it was awesome. How do I want to express my teenage angst today?
Max made me this mix CD years ago. And because it was Max, not a single song was pirated.
Pirate power.
As awesome as some of those shows with Elliot were,
They were nothing compared to Firewalk last night.
Elliot. Teen angst. Oh, that's a, that one.
Can't leave without my vitamins. Should get going.
I'm Stan Stanwyck, and I'll be with you until the top of the hour. Next up, a special present for all Arcadian Bayers, a little known band called Firewalk.
Shit, where's my phone? God, it's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
One
guess
beer.
I better try calling my phone with mom's. Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it. Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend. Maybe gray hair is his kryptonite. Maybe I should dye my hair gray. The preferred towel of Captain Bluebeard, scourge of Arcadia Bay. Home sweet home. Whoever said you can't go home again was probably from Arcadia Bay. And he could go home again. He just didn't want to. Mom's old engagement ring. It's supposed to be mine, if I'm ever stupid enough to get married. Grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pawn. Wait, Mom's selling her engagement ring? I made this for Mom when I was, like, 10 years old. If she wore it now, I'm not sure which of us would be more embarrassed. I hate that she hides all our old pictures of Dad. Dad, if you could see us now. You don't deserve to be stuck in a drawer like this.
Yeah, but if he's not dead, bad things happen.
Can't believe I used to sneak in there for her makeup. Bad enough that David comes here for dinner. Mom's finally making her bed again. I guess that's a good sign. I want Mom to be happy, but not like this. Not like this!
Guide to forgiving oneself and moving forward.
Sometimes you have to get knocked down lower than you've ever been to stand up taller than you ever were. Blech. Don't give up on yourself. A single spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie. Better.
Words of wisdom.
It's weird that Mom's always hoarding these old catalogs. It's not like we have any money. I should call my phone. How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating? Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby. All right, phone. ¿Dónde estás?
Can't go back in the room, though.
I need to find my phone before I head down there. Ugh. I drank way too much last night. Or was it just enough? There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
What's up, awkward? I'm only 40 minutes in. Being super edgy. There will be consequences. That's sad. Well, I'm glad you're excited.
Breakfast. Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah. Okay.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room. Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry.
Coming, Mom.
Didn't realize they split this up into three parts.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come. Dad took these photos. Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere. It's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that when your mom works in a diner, you're not always in the mood for diner-type food. Joyce Price, aka Mom. She looks as beat as I feel.
Go put my purse on the table before you forget.
Yeah, I remember that bubble.
Pot roast? Mom hates pot roast.
David likes it.
How can bacon smell so good, but I'd still rather stuff these sugar bombs in my mouth? Dad's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk.
What are you doing, Bubble? Crazy.
Wow. Sean Prescott's son Nathan goes to my school. Sounds like the apple didn't fall far from the asshole. Why do I suddenly want to get some fireworks?
This is Principal Ray Wells. Let me be emphatic. I have an enormous stick inserted into my butt. Thank you. Also, Chloe, you're poor and in trouble.
How was it not your fault?
Feeling trapped? Right there with you.
Rachel, spirit animal.
Little dude's like, what the hell just happened?
Well, you should probably get your brakes fixed, Bob. Probably be pretty important.
Made that for Mom in an art class when I was like 5. She was never a smoker, but it's cool. I was never an artist.
Wait, those aren't Mom's keys.
And these would be David's keys. There's probably a better place for them than the ashtray I made Mom. Like his home, maybe? From when Max and I spilled Mom's wine. I think the only reason Mom hasn't recarpeted is so she can stay mad at me.
Well, the... that deer or doe. What led them to Rachel?
It's my job to water these plants, but it was Dad's job to remind me, so. Nobody's fault, really.
Headline. Really, isn't it? Rachel's spirit animal?
We're already supporting one. Thanks. Dad always talked about upgrading to a flat screen. Too bad that never happened. I would have gotten this bad boy in my room. Family pic used to hang here. Wow. I can't actually remember.
It could be
which
either
one,
though.
From when Max and I spilled Mom's wine. I think the only reason Mom hasn't recarpeted is so she can stay mad at me.
Hard to believe I was an eighth grade science athlete. Did I peak in middle school?
Rachel Eagle Max.
Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max?
And never looked back?
I'm bad for Chloe.
Any letter from Blackwell is never good. Is Mom having trouble with payments again? My scholarship doesn't cover everything. Like I need another reason for Principal Wells to get on my case.
We all peaked in middle school. Oh, Bubble. What, by a new
Mom
one?
Doesn't want me to know,
but it's pretty clear her boy toy, David, hasn't worked in like a year.
Yes, it is, Ashley. During the writer's strike, well, they started making this game during the writer's strike. So she, or not the writer's strike, but the voice actor strike.
David's here so early. Mom calls him just a friend, but look at him. He's pretending he didn't just spend the night.
And you never saw the condoms, Chloe. You never saw the condoms.
Yeah, Max is kind of a jerk, but it happens when people move. A lot of times people drift apart.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out.
Awkward, basically, it's when they feel like they're not getting paid fairly or they need to renegotiate their contracts. And so they go on strike until they reach terms, their union reach terms for how they should be treated, like what their working conditions should be, yada yada. Means they won't work until that has been resolved.
Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
Chloe, what happened to you?
It's no big deal. I walked into a door.
You seem to be walking into a lot of doors lately. When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
Are you selling your engagement ring?
Chloe, jewelry gets appraised for all sorts of reasons. Like for insurance.
Nice dodge.
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
How about you don't ask me to get your damn purse then? You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah. An old-fashioned dickhole. Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame, too.
Well, the game was already in production. Like that. I imagine, so they had to get it done. I don't think they really had a choice.
I thought you hated pot roast.
You can have a no-thank-you helping.
No, you hate pot roast. I don't care.
I don't hate it. And David likes it. And don't say you don't care.
So that's what we're doing now? Whatever your boyfriend likes?
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah. I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Tired, huh? That'll teach you to break curfew.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that?
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? And I do know what pot smells like, you know. Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Never again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe I just need to be left alone.
Maybe you're 16 and don't know what you need. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
Your boyfriend's an asshole.
He's been good for me. Maybe he rubs you the wrong way because you've been rude.
He's still breathing. That means I've been more than fair.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not? You want me to pretend I'm okay with David? That everything's okay? I'm not. He's a chauvinistic piece of shit, frankly,
Chloe,
and...
if your father could hear you.
No, you're right. I'm sure Dad and the mustache would get along great. It's a big bed. There's room enough for all three of you.
That's Damn. Enough. All I'm asking for is a little respect. Why is that too much? I love you, Chloe. I miss you. Nobody could have replaced your father. I did the best I could.
Mom.
I don't know where I lost you.
You didn't lose me.
Right. David's waiting. He'll need the keys. They're in that ashtray you made me. Go be his problem now.
Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do.
Yeah, I like the... I don't know how I feel about the new voice. Giving her a shot, though. She sounds like she's trying a little too hard sometimes, so...
No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. I better get going.
Playing into the ting angst.
Mom doesn't want me to know, but it's pretty clear her boy toy, David, hasn't worked in like a year.
Okay.
What a piece of crap. The car, too.
Why do you women always take forever to get ready?
We're hoping you men will leave without us. No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
I'll snap your fingers and point. Come on.
Chloe, is that a black eye?
No.
Insubordination. No wonder your mother's worried about you.
Oh, that's sweet.
When I was your age, I got into my share of scraps. But it's not responsible. You owe it to your mother to do better.
Tell me again what I owe my mother, dirtbag.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites.
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket wrench and get this over with.
This is Life is Strange, Jeff.
Mom should date literally anyone else. Wait, isn't that a socket wrench right there?
Where's the socket wrench set again? All I see in the garage is family stuff. You know, not your stuff.
Dick around on your own time. It's in the toolbox. In the garage. Won't be late to school on my watch.
Tiniest penis in all of Arcadia Bay. What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something? Should fill this with gasoline just in case David's car ever catches on fire.
It's not that kind of game.
Damn. The stereo used to be in Dad's workshop. I should hook it up in my room before Garbage Day gets it first.
Prequel to the game Life is Strange.
Dad's old camera. Do they even make film for these anymore?
Whereas in the original Life is Strange, you're from the point of view of a girl named Max, and this one, point of view of Chloe, but three years earlier
Mom's
than that storyline.
This was the photo Mom took down from the living room. Guess we don't have room for it and David's mustache. David's lawnmower. Maybe Mom and I like our lawn the way it is. Ever think of that? Dad's toolbox. He used to get so excited whenever anything sprung a leak or busted.
There's the picture that's in their backyard.
Do these have chapters on hotwiring your mom's boyfriend's car so you can drive it off a cliff? Asking for a friend.
They already have attacked Jeffrey.
By toolbox, did David mean this, or did he mean himself?
Wish she had written on her hand.
There's his stupid socket wrench set. Let's get this shit show over with. 50-50 chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10.
I couldn't grab this one. Can't grab both of them.
So?
You find the socket wrench set yet? You can do that one simple thing, can't you? A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you. See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special, David.
All right.
Sure, why not? Let's be nice for once.
Whatever. Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
We've already got one, but thanks.
What are you referring to, Jeffrey?
Ready to roll?
Please don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I
want
to talk to you about something.
Fuck.
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there's some things I want to be real clear about.
Mm-hmm.
Joyce, your mother, she's hurting, Chloe. Hurting for you. You've had it rough, no doubt about it. But all this staying out late, ignoring her command, drinking, drug use, it's making everything harder for her. You need to shape up, get your act together, and put someone else first for a damn change. Am I making myself clear?
Is it crazy if part of what David's saying makes sense to me?
Got it. Thanks. We should really get going.
Glad we understand each other.
What are you talking about, Jeffrey?
Country music? Dad loved this song. I just called to tell you that I miss you, my friend. What a beautiful day. I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad. This isn't right.
Nightmare.
If Mom were here, she'd tell him to turn that junk off.
Dad, turn it up.
Oh, were you able to read it? Or are you just making up things? What do you think it might be?
Hey.
The hell?
Out of the car, Chloe. You're gonna be late.
Shit. Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young lady. I can see you rolling your eyes.
Hello? I was actually saying
I see everything.
That'd be nice if he's a dick.
Hello, Black Hell.
Hey, Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
Wait, what happened to your face? Do you need to go to the nurse or something?
What? This? You should see the other guy.
Guess it's true then. I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
People can eat a dick. Even social media haters can't ruin how awesome last night was.
So, how about the Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you want to go together tomorrow?
try to make it a rule not to go to school any more than I have to. But sitting in the back row and making fun of the drama kids might not suck.
Right? That's totally what I was thinking.
Yeah, were you able to read it, Jeffrey?
See you and Cam.
Yeah, for sure.
Gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class.
On my hand. There it is. I don't remember Elliot from the first game.
Maybe this play won't suck. Maybe. How could I possibly make it through a day in this place without a little chemical assistance? Meh. Well, at least not for now.
Now we know what it says.
I can tell Justin's wearing his eau de gange.
Damn, girl. That eye looks sick. What's going on?
Last night, I scoped out this crazy party at the old mill up north. Kind of a DIY thing.
Wow, no shit. I thought that place was like meth central. My cousin met this hooker there.
Whatever. It was cool, okay? You wouldn't understand. Hey, out of the blue question, what do you think of Rachel Amber?
She's amazing. If you're into chicks that are hot, smart, and hot. I mean, she helped me out a while back. I was failing algebra hard.
I believe you.
Check it. After I bombed my midterm last fall, she tutored me for the rest of the semester. And then I crushed it. C+.
All right. Guess I'll see you in class.
Word.
Well, they're in Oregon, so I hope it wasn't a Confederate statue.
The future needs excellence. The future's an asshole. Victoria Chase. I'd rather vomit razor blades than talk to her.
Ah, Carrie Price!
It's Chloe.
Oh, right. I'm just teasing. People have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography.
You don't say.
Between that and the Vortex Club, it's hard to keep people from putting me up on a pedestal or whatever. But you know all about that. What with Rachel Amber? Am I right?
You hang with the Vortex Club?
I mean, I'm technically not a member, but I am being courted.
I'm not sure
I... The club should be a collection of Blackwell elites, but instead, it's some anti-bullying, hand-holding kumbaya shit. Not when I'm a senior.
Wait, what about Rachel Amber?
Rachel posted a slamming selfie of you two having the time of your lives. Do tell.
It was a pretty normal night for us. A little music, a little dancing, we murdered a guy.
You are so funny. Oh, seriously though, I didn't realize you and Rachel were such BFFs.
We're really not.
So, what's she into? You know, what's her thing? Is it drugs? I'm not judging or anything. I figure if she's hanging out with you, she must be into some effed up shit.
Trying to get dirt on her.
Seriously, I don't know why you're talking to me about Rachel.
Oh, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
So you're jealous of Rachel Amber. That's what's happening right now. Gotcha.
Oh, God, I don't have time for this. I didn't even finish the chemistry assignment, and you're being you. Ugh.
I'm sorry, Victoria. I didn't mean to be rude. You know, I finished the assignment. Want some help?
You? Help me?
Of course. That last problem was hard, right? If I'm remembering correctly, the answer was fluorine, uranium, carbon, potassium, and, uranium again. Does that sound right?
Perfect. Hey! Thanks, Carrie.
No problem.
Like high school. Yep.
Skip Matthews, Blackwell's finest. He's not so bad for a mall cop. Hey, Skip. Stopped any gang wars lately?
Not today.
Oof, looks like you did, though.
Huh? Ah, right. Whatever.
I did ask Justin Williams' mom to move her Mercedes out of handicapped parking.
Badass.
Yeah, you know how I roll.
So, I went to the mill last night. Caught Firewalk live.
You went to the mill? Wait, you saw Firewalk?
It was cool.
Whoa, pretty wicked. I didn't know you were into music like that.
What? Like good music?
Preach it, sister. I'm in a band, actually.
No shit. Really?
We're called Pisshead. It's not a big deal or anything. I mean, I'm trying to get our demo out there, but it's hard.
Pisshead, huh?
Would you maybe want to hear it? Our demo, I mean.
Why not?
Yeah, okay.
Great. So, what did you think?
Bye.
That was really good, man.
Give him a confidence booster.
If Pisshead came on the radio, I'd turn that shit up.
Oh, right on. Awesome, Chloe, thanks.
Miss Grant, the least lame teacher at Blackwell. Wish she could get over the whole push me to succeed thing, though. Morning, Miss Grant.
Chloe, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
What do you think of this hypothesis? That you'll be in your seat by the time chemistry class begins today?
Science is all about discovery, Miss Grant. Guess you'll have to wait and see.
With all the change that's happening at Blackwell of late, I suppose I can appreciate your consistent wit, Chloe.
What kind of change do you mean?
Well, the Prescotts have made an extremely generous donation to the school, which is good, but instead of going to support more science and mathematics, it's all being dedicated to the arts.
You don't think more money should be spent in the arts?
It's not that exactly. I recently made the case that STEM programs should receive more support, but apparently our new donors disagree with me. Such is life, I suppose.
Miss Grant actually seems sad. Maybe in another 6 months, a new donor will come along with money for, I don't know, more lasers.
More lasers?
Do we have any lasers?
Sadly, no.
That is sad.
I'll see you in class, right, Chloe?
Need my DVD from Steph. I bet she's nerding it up with Mikey somewhere. I prefer to wake and bake, but hey, to each their own.
Yeah, she's got like that whole like I'm a badass walk going on.
But fire's so pretty. What the fuck is that supposed to mean?
Hulk Hogan. Walk on the stage, so I'm gonna do it anyways.
I should probably be getting to class, but I just don't care. Principal Wells.
Hey.
Stay cool, Chloe. You've got a marijuana-flavored bag of expulsion in your pocket.
Chloe Price. Is that a black eye?
All the voices are different.
Yep.
I hope you know that Blackwell provides confidential counseling services for all our students. We are a safe space for any issue.
I'm good. It's the other guy who needed a safe space. From me.
You never fail to conform to your reputation, do you? Miss Price, the sign clearly says do not walk on the stage. Such disregard for your fellow students' efforts won't alleviate your record of major infractions.
I swear to you, I did not walk on that stage. It was more of a saunter.
Do I look amused to you?
I don't know. I've only seen you with one expression. That's the one.
Perhaps you will find me less amusing if I mention the various allegations I've been hearing about your drug use. You know Blackwell has a zero-tolerance policy.
No, they didn't, Jeffrey.
And yet if my olfactory sense does not fail me, I'd say you've recently been exposed to marijuana smoke.
Shit.
Do I have to initiate a search of your person in order to establish the veracity of these allegations, Miss Price? That's what I thought. I'll look forward to seeing you in my office after school today. How does that sound?
All right, sir. I'll see you after school.
I'll count the minutes.
That guy's a tool. Flowers always make me think of springtime, which makes me think of summer, which makes me think of getting the fuck away from Blackwell for 3 whole months. I love flowers. This makes being high sound like a bad thing. Evan's work is actually pretty good. I'd never tell him that, of course. Samantha Myers, school wallflower. She could give you a run for your money, Max.
Hey, Chloe.
Hey, Samantha. What are you reading?
Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
I read that last year in Mrs. Hoyta's English class.
I didn't think you did homework.
Normally I don't, but the play was actually good.
What did you like about it?
The story is about how relationships only work if people are willing to lie to each other.
I'm not sure if you're joking. Sorry, I'm a little slow sometimes.
I'm a little bitchy sometimes, so it's cool.
People always say that. But I think you're actually... Sorry, Chloe. No one says anything like that. I don't know what I'm actually talking about.
I bet.
You have some sad eyes.
I really didn't mean anything.
Evan. Amazing photographer, but such a bleeding heart. What soapbox is he on today?
Chloe, I'd like to talk to you about wildfire awareness and prevention.
Good morning to you too, Evan.
According to the Department of Forestry, over 90% of this season's fires were caused by humans. That's a record high and completely preventable.
Who says we should prevent fire? Fire is awesome.
While I realize you're being purposefully obstructive, you raise a good point. Many parts of our local ecosystem benefit from fire. Knobcone pine cones, for example, which require temperatures above 350 degrees to open.
Say knobcone again.
No.
This is for college, right? I don't believe you actually care about this.
I don't think she needs any worse luck.
My interest in fire prevention is completely sincere. Besides, I intend to get into college on the strength of my photography alone. Do you think Rachel Amber would be willing to pose for my portfolio? She's so artistic. I bet she would be a dream model. What do you think?
I guess. I gotta run.
Wait, one last thing. Will you sign my petition to have a fire safety assembly at school?
Sure. I love assemblies. Some of the best naps of my life.
Wow, thanks. I did not see that coming. You being, you know, interested in complicated issues, helping out with the public.
Do you want me to change my mind?
No.
How seriously am I taking this right now?
We'd
happy
be there.
To support such an important cause. Blackwell Academy, home of tomorrow's leaders.
Thanks so much for signing my petition. Smokeweed D-Bear?
Only you can prevent ganja fires.
Hey, I still signed it at least. Dungeons and Dragons.
Steph Gingrich and Mikey North, Blackwell's premier indoor kids. Steph has created something of a business selling pirated DVDs to other students.
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
Who, Chloe?
Give me a break, nerds. I've heard of tabletop games.
Cool.
Got my DVD?
One Blade Runner. Director's cut coming right up.
Sweet. $5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Rachel Amber? You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just, like, a friend thing?
I don't know what you heard, but Rachel and I barely know each other.
Oh, sweet.
Steph has a crush.
Chloe, you should join her game.
Yeah. I don't have 50 hours right now. Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else have you got to do before class?
Sure, why not?
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Nice. I could totally see myself as an elf barbarian.
I know, I'm good. All right, Let's get started. You are both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well. Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you in greeting. I am Elamon, Wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernum.
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named,
Barb.
Barb.
No. Steph.
Hey, give Barb a chance, okay? The two heroes.
Hold on.
Hold back, Bobo.
Narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
I once stabbed a guy in the chest with a sword, and it went all the way through and killed the guy behind him, too. True story.
That
you
face.
You stand at a three-way crossing. To your left, the raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the dude.
Elamon frowns. The raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Your choice, newbie. Where do you wish to go?
It's tent time.
Are you sure you want to skip the training ground and the prison camp?
Okay, let me pick again.
Where do you wish to go?
Guess it's time to free some peeps. Let's go to the prison camp.
You behold a field of standing iron cages, each imprisoning a human villager, calling out for you to free them. Only a small, elderly dragonkin is keeping watch. He notices you, and in terror, runs into one of the few empty cages and locks himself in.
Ah, poor little guy. What's a dragonkin?
Dragonkin are like little dragon people.
They said no,
they're
Bubble.
Assholes.
Not in this.
I bet he has all the keys.
Oh, okay.
The max thing.
Hey, shitface! Get out of there!
The dragonkin hops up and down, shaking his ring of keys at you. He shouts in a strange language. Whatever he's saying probably isn't flattering.
Got any useful spells in that robe of yours?
Nothing that wouldn't blow up the cage and everything in it.
Intimidate. That's a skill I have. Can I do that? I want the little bastard to shit his pants.
You can try. What do you say?
Listen up, you little lizard.
Unfortunately, he doesn't speak common, which means he can't-
I cast communication on the dragonkin.
Shit. Really?
Now he can understand every word you say.
Time to work some real magic.
So this is called a skill challenge, where you try to use-
Oh, I know what this is. I grab the bars of the cage and lean in, nice and close.
He steps back, his scaly skin quivering in fear. What do you say?
Everybody knows that dragons are pussies. That's why they hide in caves and only come out to breathe fire on sheep and eat cows and shit.
That was a mistake. The dragonkin growls, snapping at you and showing his teeth and claws. Tall one is a fool. Dragons are gods, he says.
Damn.
You're short, I say. But I could fix that. I'll just cut off your head and wear it as a top hat. Then you'd be way taller.
No, no, please don't do that. Still, I cannot give key. Durgaron will eat me.
I think he's close to breaking.
I show him my fist. I call this the Ripper, because it's really good for reaching down dragonkin throats and ripping out dragonkin stomachs.
The dragonkin cowers before you, looking left and right. He opens his jaws, and you think he's about to yell for help.
I interrupt his yell by shoving my axe into the cage, pinning his head to the bars without hurting him. Then I say the following.
This is going to be good.
Here's what's up. I'm going to carve the skin from your bones. Then I'm going to turn your skin into a little leather handbag that I'll shove your skinless body into so I can carry it around with me wherever I go. That way, the next time some asshat refuses to give me a key I want, I can pull your body out and show them what happens. How does that sound?
Wow.
That was...
All right, Jeffrey, thanks for stopping in, man.
I'm going to give you a plus 10 bonus to charisma. Go ahead and roll. A small pool of urine collects under the elderly dragonkin as, hands trembling, it hands you the keys. Then it dies of fear.
Awesome.
Yeah!
Go team! Why don't you start unlocking the prisoners?
I'm on it.
As you free them, the prisoners run away from you in fear. What's next?
Loot sounds good. Let's go to the training ground.
Sweet.
Upon arriving at the training ground, you are spotted by a heavy-set orc who immediately shouts and points. There are a dozen raiders on the training field, all of whom raise their weapons and charge.
Okay. So what do we do?
I cast Urgul's Acid Blast.
Overkill?
Bam!
You conjure up a wave of acid that washes over the charging orcs. Every raider suddenly starts screaming and writhing in pain. There's a sweet and sour kind of smell as the flesh melts off their bones like warm candle wax.
Holy shit.
You see Brutal. Why I haven't really needed a partner?
The heavy-set orc sergeant still remains. He runs at you, swinging a massive warhammer.
All yours.
I knee him. Right in the orc balls.
Success! The orc clutches his groin, never to father children again.
Ouch!
Your turn again, Chloe.
Okay, let's end this. Fatal cleave!
You swing your great axe downward with both hands.
I didn't even get
the
to see the roll.
The orc blinks, then splits open like a hot dog bun.
Fuck yeah! I'm awesome at this game!
It's going well.
What about the loot?
Well, as the training ground is now a roiling pit of acid, it's unlikely any loot survived.
Dang.
My character raises her axe. You'll pay for ruining all that loot, Elamon.
By my honor, I apologize. Here, take this potion as a gift.
Thanks, dude.
What's next?
Only thing that's left.
It's tent time.
You enter the tent to find Durgaron, warlord of the raiders of the Black Well, sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur, swathed in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows, wah ha ha ha. Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
What an asshole.
I got this. I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
The fire fizzles out on contact. Durgaron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit. All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Except for, you know, Acid Blast, which someone used unnecessarily to show off for Chloe. Arb, what'll it be?
Oh, holy shit! Annihilation Strike! That sounds boss as fuck!
One?
That's bad, right?
Not for me. As you take your first step, you trip on a rock. Collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal. Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Oh no. 3.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg.
Legs. Plural. Severing both feet at the ankles.
This game is awesome.
My feet?
Durgaron moves toward the crippled Elmon.
Oh, shit!
I told you this was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgaron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp, stomp, stomp.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What should I do?
Jump.
Alright, jump in front of Elmon.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe. I mean, thanks, Barb.
Okay. Durgaron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
Shit!
Oh, no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgaron laughs as he impales you on his blade, lifting you high into the air.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey, I chopped your feet off. We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgaron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell. What do you do?
I bring my axe down onto his arm. The one with the fire bracer thingy.
Oh. Brilliant!
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
20!
Fuck yes!
You bring your axe down in a wicked chop, severing his arm completely. His bracer of fire immunity clangs to the ground.
I cast Gignomi's Fire Strike of Flame!
Ooh, snap!
Lying on the ground, you conjure a flaming spear, which flies from your hands to spear Durgaron in the chest, incinerating him completely from the inside out.
Damn, Elamon.
Durgaron is defeated, but your wounds were too great. I'm afraid Barb is dead.
I actually feel sad right now.
Dead in a blaze of glory.
Better to have died a hero than live as a coward.
That was fun.
Check out what I drew.
Maggie's got serious drawing skills.
Glad you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
We'll see. Thanks for the game, nerds. DVD, check. Next stop, chemistry class. Joy.
Alright, once again, the school here, I'm gonna call it night. It'll probably auto-save me when I go in.
What the hell?
What have you got here, Twitch? Don't call me that!
Is that Nathan North. Prescott?
The jock's so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Oh, wow. This is some really weird crap, Prescott.
It's not yours! Give it back!
I hate that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
Guys, no need to fight. You can both be losers.
The mute speaks? Whoa, whoa! You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
At least my family pays tuition. How much financial aid does your deadbeat dad need again?
Wow. Dick move, Nathan.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard when your dad closed it down. And you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone.
You know something, Prescott? I'm gonna do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
Wow, someone's actually siding with Nathan?
Piece of shit. I am going to kill you!
You guys, stop! Chloe, do something! Don't just stand there watching!
The only way to stop a bully is to be aggressive.
We'll go for it.
Put Drew down.
Back off, idiot.
the hell did you just say to me?
Idiot. You're not used to a word that big, are you? Don't be scared.
You're seriously defending Nathan Prescott?
How about picking on someone your own size? Which I hear is pretty small.
You're such a crazy freak. Mind your own business.
When Nathan goes crying to Lord Prescott, everybody here will be stuck doing sensitivity seminars all week.
You want a piece of this?
You mean your budding bromance with Nathan? You're clearly into him. Just pull his hair already.
You think this is funny? You think I'm joking here?
Think? That's a fancy word for you, Drew. Careful with it.
I win.
Did you just laugh?
I did. Chloe just owned you.
Shut the fuck up, fresh meat.
You shut the fuck up.
Go Samantha.
Guess you got lucky this time, Prescott. Had two girls show up to save you. Take your pervy picture book.
Are you okay?
You think I need help? From you?
You're welcome.
Are you all right? Thanks for sticking up for him. People think just because of his family.
Everything okay here?
No problem, Skip.
Just knowing what happened to Nathan, what was going on with him, makes me feel sorry for him in this game.
That pick would actually make a sweet tattoo. Maybe if I delay going inside long enough, Blackwall will be overrun by future excellence. And by future ex-
Oops.
Oh, good. You're here.
Alright, peeps. I'm gonna go ahead and call it here.
I do beseech you.
I'll pause, so that way, next stream I'll start off with that cutscene. I will be back tomorrow, but tomorrow is Terror Tuesday, so we'll be playing some more Dead Space, and then continue on with Life is Strange on Wednesday. Should be able to finish it by Friday, depending if I'm doing Bro v Bro. We'll see. That's gonna do it, guys. Thanks for tuning in. And I'll be back tomorrow with Terror Tuesday. If you want to watch more Life is Strange, that'll be back on Wednesday. As always, thanks for tuning in. Catch you guys later. Have a good night.